Summary. We will make a complete drum machine in this video and make that as a track template. So next time when you want to load this drum machine, you don't have to repeat all these things again and again. Only you have to load the track template and that's it, you have a complete drum machine in your project in just 2 to 3 clicks. Before doing all these below steps, create a new project, because if you do all these below things in your existing project, it might mess your project. So here we go. Step 1, insert new track by double clicking on the TCP. This track is used as a folder for all your drum machine tracks. This track is also used as a master volume, pan for all your drum sounds. This track is also used as master effects for all your drum sounds. Like adding reverb or delay to every drum sound. Step 2, right-click on the TCP and insert virtual instrument on new track and select SITALA. Then click on yes when asked for routing stereo outputs. It is necessary to insert virtual instrument rather than insert new track. Because it will automatically set everything, otherwise you manually have to click on few other things to set it up. Step 3, assign each drum sounds into different Reaper track. Go to SITALA plugin. Click on the 3 dots in the right corner. Click on audio output. Click on 16 channel output, 1 channel per pad. Now you can see, each drum sound has output in different Reaper tracks. Previously, outputs for all drum sounds was in just single track, which is definitely not needed. Step 4, make the track, which we created in step 1, as a folder for all your drum tracks. Just do like I am showing you in this video. Click on that little icon for just one time to make that track as a folder. This is very important because it not only works as a folder for better organization, but also works as a drum bus, as I mentioned in the step 1. You can see I did 2 clicks on a little icon in the last track just to tell Reaper that this is the last track of my folder. If I create more tracks after this, don't add them inside this folder, add them outside this folder. So, it's very important to do those 2 clicks. Step 5, name the tracks like this. So that you know which track do which thing. Name the folder track as drums, audio, because this works as a folder and drum bus, and we can manipulate the sound of all drum sounds from this track. Name the SITALA track as drums, MIDI, because in this track, we will program our drum machine, we will make beats here. Note, don't add effects into MIDI track because it just doesn't work at all, neither the volume panning works in the MIDI track. So, the MIDI track is strictly for programming your drum sounds, making beats etc. So in short, only SITALA plugin will be there in the MIDI track, nothing else. Step 6, now, select all 18 tracks you have created so far. Then right-click on the first track and click on Save Tracks as Track Template. Name that track template as Drum Machine or whatever you like to name. Done. Next time, when you want to load this drum machine, just right-click on the TCP. Select Insert Track from Template. And choose your drum machine name which you named in the step 5. Thank you for watching. I hope I helped you. Write your queries in the comment section, if you have any problem. Have a nice day, smiley face.